Introduction. The class develops the possible failures of the car's anti-pollution system, which transforms polluting gases into less harmful compounds with the main objective of complying with current environmental regulations and minimizing the negative impact on the environment. Index. Components, operation and failures of anti-pollution systems. Tips to prevent future failures in the anti-pollution system. Subscribe to the Fleet Management channel. Your subscription is a great support to continue making new videos. Subscribe. 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 Components, operation and failure of anti-pollution systems. Modern vehicles are equipped with anti-pollution systems. They are designed to comply with current road regulations and promote more sustainable driving. This system, made up of a set of advanced technologies, is indispensable in reducing the polluting emissions that cars generate while running. What is the anti-pollution system and how does it work? The anti-pollution system is composed of several technologies such as oxygen sensors, catalytic converters, and exhaust gas recirculation systems, EGR. These technologies work together to optimize engine combustion and transform pollutant gases into less harmful compounds. This includes reducing substances such as carbon monoxide, nitrogen oxides, and hydrocarbons that are harmful to human health and the environment. The main objective is to comply with current environmental regulations and minimize the negative impact on the environment. Operation of the technologies involved. The anti-pollution system of a car is composed of several technologies, which are oxygen sensors. They detect the amount of oxygen in the exhaust gases and send this information to the engine control unit, which adjusts the air-fuel mixture to optimize combustion. Catalytic converter transforms harmful gases such as carbon monoxide, nitrogen oxides, and hydrocarbons into carbon dioxide, nitrogen, and water vapor, which are less harmful to the environment. EGR system recirculates part of the exhaust gases to the engine to reduce combustion temperatures and thus the formation of nitrogen oxides, one of the main pollutants. Particulate filter retains polluting particles or soot in the exhaust gases. The particulate filter is capable of absorbing up to 99% of the pollutants, and when the car detects that it has exceeded its absorption capacity limit, a regeneration is programmed, which consists of reducing the pollutant particles to ashes thanks to a burning process. These filters can work with or without chemical additives, although most cars use them without them. Lambda sensor, it controls the ratio of oxygen to fuel in the combustion of the engine to make it efficient. Common causes of anti-pollution system failures. There are several reasons why an anti-pollution system may fail. Some of the most common causes include the use of low-quality fuel or fuel with impurities, carbon buildup in the oxygen sensors or catalytic converter. A defective oxygen sensor prevents proper adjustment of the air-fuel mixture, increasing emissions and fuel consumption. Problems with the fuel injection system, a fault in the ignition system, the use of low-quality engine oil, failures in the lambda sensor, leakage in the exhaust gas recirculation system. Failure in the EGR system. Problems with the exhaust gas recirculation system can lead to increased NOx emissions and poor engine performance. Causes overheating and loss of power, resulting in activation of the engine warning light. Clogged catalytic converter reduces the vehicle's ability to convert harmful gases, affecting performance and ability to pass emissions tests. Clogged particulate filter. It prevents the correct expulsion of gases and can cause performance problems and increased emissions. In order for the particulate filter to perform an optimal regeneration, it is necessary to maintain a constant speed at high revolutions during a period of approximately 20 minutes. If regeneration stops in the middle of the journey, either because the driver wants it to or because the vehicle is left in reserve, the check engine light may be displayed on the instrument panel, indicating a possible failure in the anti-pollution system. If the usual journeys are made in the city, the possibility of driving at high revolutions at constant speed decreases, the vehicle is not able to carry out regenerations properly, and the particulate filter stores soot, becoming saturated. When this happens, the check engine light on the instrument panel also warns of the malfunction. If the vehicle continues to circulate under these conditions, an internal rupture may occur within the filter itself, causing engine failure, which may be affected by the backflow of exhaust gases. The anti-pollution system has a differential pressure sensor whose mission is to measure the exhaust gases before and after the particulate filter. When the pressure exceeds the limit set by the manufacturer, the sensor orders the electronic control unit, ECU, to regenerate. This sensor is an electrical part. If it breaks down, it can send erroneous information and not perform the regenerations in the proper time or form. These are some of the causes, but it must be taken into account that the average life of a particulate filter is usually about 150,000 kilometers, so this must also be taken into account.
Learned about our fleet management consulting and training services. Reduce costs and optimize fleet management activities. We electrify your fleet of vehicles. We carry out the electrification plan until its implementation, known as.
Tips to prevent future anti-pollution system failures. How to detect a failure in the anti-pollution system. Today's vehicles are highly controlled by electronics and indicate those errors that they may have, so that we pay attention to them and go to a specialized workshop to solve them. What are the signs that indicate that the anti-pollution system may be failing? Here are a series of symptoms. The engine malfunction light on the dashboard comes on. Engine performance is affected. You notice that the vehicle is consuming more fuel than normal. The car's emissions increase. The exhaust smoke is blacker than usual. Solutions to fix an anti-pollution system failure. If a failure in the anti-pollution system is detected, it is essential to take the vehicle to a mechanic to have it checked. A malfunction in this system may even damage the engine and cause a major failure. In addition, gas emission standards would be violated and this can lead to fines. The best solution to fix a failure in the vehicle's anti-pollution system is to take it to the workshop to see the origin and change what is necessary. Some of the solutions to fix any of these faults may be: replace a defective oxygen sensor, replace the EGR valve, clean the catalytic converter and oxygen sensors, replace a deficient fuel injection, replacing a damaged ignition system. Tips to prevent future anti-pollution system failures. Failures in the anti-pollution system can be avoided and thus extend the useful life of the particulate filter. In order to do it, it is necessary to follow a series of recommendations that what they will achieve is to improve the performance of the car, use high-quality fuel, and to maintain the adequate level, not to circulate with the car in the reserve of habitual way. Perform regular maintenance of the vehicle, including the revision and change of engine oil. Do not drive with the engine malfunction light on. This can cause further damage to the anti-pollution system. Avoid using additives or chemicals not recommended for the vehicle. Make a thorough check of the car before buying it secondhand, because it may have undetected anti-pollution problems. Do not interrupt the car's regeneration process. Use a low ash motor oil. Check and change filters. Make sure air and particulate filters are not clogged to avoid affecting system efficiency. Regular inspection of sensors and converters. Replace oxygen sensors and check the catalytic converter regularly to prevent blockages and failures. EGR system monitoring. Clean and check this system to prevent blockages and ensure it is working properly. Keeping the anti-pollution system in good condition is not only an environmental responsibility, but also a necessity to ensure the efficient operation of the vehicle. With regular care and maintenance, you can contribute significantly to reducing pollution and extending the life of your car. In conclusion, the most important thing is to detect anti-pollution system failures as early as possible and take the vehicle to a mechanic for repair.